Happening in town, the LSU Tigers take on the Alabama Crimson Tide in the BCS title game in the Superdome. And the feeling on the streets here in the city, simply electric. Tonight we have team coverage for you of the game and, of course, all the fans.
Whether you pull for the Tigers or the Tide, the game and all the national attention is a big win for New Orleans. We have crews live at the Superdome on Bourbon Street and at one of the biggest LSU RV parks. Plus, Chief Meteorologist Margaret Orr will show us our rain chances for this evening.
But we begin with the hottest ticket in town. Industry experts say that the most expensive ticket in college football history.
And unfortunately, there are some con artists out there looking to rip off fans. WDSU News reporter Travers Mackle joins us live from the Dome to explain how police are cracking down on these fake tickets. Travers?
That's right, Scott. Fans are flowing into the Superdome right now, as Camille just mentioned. This is maybe the hottest ticket in the city of New Orleans, arguably ever, at least since 2006 and the Saints' Dome coming game. People are paying thousands of dollars for these tickets. A lot of con men, a lot of bogus tickets out there, but police say they are on top of this. It's like carnival season come early in the French Quarter. Thousands of fans getting ready for the BCS National Championship game. James Davis has his ticket ready.
And thankfully, I paid $350 for mine. So we had offers for a block of four for about $20,000, but it wasn't worth it.
Like Davis, Eddie Beauchair paid face value for his ticket to get to the game.
I knew someone and who knew someone, and I was fortunate enough to get a ticket.
But tickets are being sold for well over face value on many online sites, which means people have to pay attention to who they buy from and who is collecting their money. Law enforcement leaders say make sure you buy from a legitimate site or broker. Cops say they take scalping seriously, as it's illegal to sell a ticket for more than face value within 700 feet of the Superdome.
Anytime we have an event around the Superdome and the arena, we have officers who are working, looking for scalping. You know, you can't sell anything on the street above face value, and if somebody tries to do that, chances are they're trying to take advantage of you. So we have officers in blue jeans and t-shirts that you wouldn't expect to be people trying to buy tickets, and we want to run that out. We don't want that going on.
Back in 2008, the I-team found ticket scalpers selling tickets within feet of Orleans Parish Civil Sheriff's deputies before a Hornets playoff basketball game. The sheriff and NOPD told us back then they were not turning a blind eye to scalpers. Good news for fans looking to make a last-minute buy.
I couldn't have afforded that, so I'm glad I was able to get my ticket for around face value.
And there are a handful of people around the Superdome selling those tickets. Obviously, something police take very seriously. They do say if you are coming down here and you are looking for that last-minute ticket, try to buy from a reputable dealer or a reputable website. They say buyer beware if you buy from somebody who is essentially a street hustler trying to pass a ticket off, and they're trying to make sure that that doesn't happen, as you heard from Superintendent Ronald Surpass. For now, reporting on your side outside of the Superdome, I'm Travers Mackle. Scott and Camille, back to you.
All right, Travers.